Scotlandville.
Ladies and gentlemen, we got finest up in here tonight. Ladies and gentlemen.
As we journey through our childhood into adulthood, we begin to notice natural gifts, talents, and enjoyable hobbies begin to emerge within us. As a child, we're often asked, what do you want to be when you grow up? Oftentimes, it's not considered that what we enjoy doing should bring us financial gain. What if we begin to look at our children's natural gifts, talents, and passions, nurture them, prepare them to pursue a career in that area, and propel them to begin a business that offers services to our communities, offers services statewide, nationwide, and even worldwide. I believe that not only would that person enjoy what they're doing, but the client will receive an outstanding experience. Well, that was me. I was home from college, baking with my family, and Y2K was approaching. And if anybody remember about Y2K, you will remember it released paranoia about what the year 2000 would bring. Personally, I was concerned about store closures. How would I get my sugar to bake my weekly treats? Then I remembered I had been collecting recipes that contained honey. Well, that was it. I would begin researching how to take care of honeybees, which brought me back to my college studies when I was with my professors conducting experiments on their research animals. But this time, it would be my research, bee search. Now that's how Hilltop Apiary began. I received my first package of honeybees. Man, I admired these little creatures, how they worked together, they communicated with one another to build a solid home from nothing but a thin layer of beeswax. One hive multiplied into five hives. Five hives led to 11 hives. 11 hives led to 30 hives. 30 hives led to 65 hives. I know y'all get the picture. These small insects are so powerful. Did you all know that 90% of all the plants in our environment require pollination? 33% of the foods we eat are pollinated by honeybees. Melons, strawberries, blackberries, blueberries, citrus fruits, tomatoes, squash, just to name a few, are all pollinated by honeybees. Almond farmers in California, they spend hundreds of thousands of dollars to bring honeybees across the United States to their farms to pollinate their almond trees. The assurance of their almond trees being pollinated by the honeybees, it's worth the honeybee's travel. Not only do these honeybees create an intricate home for themselves, but their pollinating of woody shrubs and trees create a diverse habitat for many insects and animals. Honeybees are very clean. The females are the workers. They are constantly cleaning their hives of the debris, and they're sanitizing the honeycomb to put nectar in. These ladies will travel up to 5 miles to find nectar. It takes about 12 honeybees to make 1 teaspoon of honey after they have visited millions of flowers. I know that you all have heard busy as a bee, but these ladies literally work themselves to death. in their short 6 weeks lifespan, they're out foraging for nectar and storing honey for the next generation. They are legacy builders. They are providing food for the next generation, in which they may never consume themselves. With that said, the appearance and buzzing of honeybees in our environment are great indicators of how well our environment is doing. The honeybee pollination in our environment will yield at least a 33% increase in our fruits and vegetables in our gardens, a 33% increase on our farms. Here's our sesumetry. It's healthy, it's full of green leaves, but it has minimal fruit. The next year, we decide to put a honeybee hive in our yard. Take a look at it now. It's healthy, but it's loaded with fruit. Each fruit you see on there began as a flower that was pollinated. Flowers on a tree that are visited more often by honeybees will create a more uniform and larger fruit. Honeybee pollination and the medicinal uses of honeybee products can be greatly influential to us. Did you know that honey has antibacterial, antifungal, anti-inflammatory, and antiviral properties? Honey has antioxidants that can boost the immune system. Honey has properties that can stimulate cellular growth. It can promote healing of wounded and chapped skin. Pollen is a great topper for smoothie and yogurts and cereals, but it contains 27 essential amino acids, enzymes, minerals, and proteins that sustain the life of a honeybee. It is also known as bee bread. Propolis, it's a sticky substance that honeybees excrete. They use it to seal their honeybee hives to make sure that it maintains an optimal temperature. Propolis is also considered as a bee glue. They use it to protect their beehive from bacteria. Okay? Propolis can be found in toothpaste, ointments, nasal and throat sprays. Beeswax is also secreted by the honeybee. They're going to use it to build their honeycomb, to store their honey and pollen. The queen bee also lays her eggs in the honeycomb. We can find beeswax in some soaps, lotions, facial products, hair products, and even candles. Did you know that bee venom's anti-inflammatory properties are commonly used in acupuncture? The most interesting, I believe, of all the bee products is the royal jelly. The honeybees, they feed it directly to the queen bee, and they also put it in the cells with the growing larva for food. Royal jelly slows aging. It extends that queen bee's life from the mere 6 weeks of a female worker to 6 years. That's a phenomenon. Just think, I went to college in pursuit of pre-medicine, but my curiosity about beekeeping led to my personal research, my training, which led to a financial pathway, entrepreneurship, which allowed me to be able to help support biodiversity in our ecosystem. Thank you for attending my TED Talk.